Hello and welcome. In this tutorial, we will evaluate a trained deep learning model. Evaluation in this context means that we check the performance of a trained deep learning model on independent data to make sure that the model is good enough to be deployed. For this video, I adapted the third example in this series on HALCON object detection. In the example, you can use either a model that was pre-trained by MVTech or the model you trained yourself with the previous example. For this video, we use a model from an earlier epoch that doesn't perform very well. When running the example, the first thing that is displayed are inference results on some randomly selected images of the test split. For the visualization, the standard procedure DevDisplayDLData is used. In this visualization, the upper label ID and the transparent box represent the ground truth bounding box, while the lower label ID and the bounding box with the solid border represent the detected bounding box. Also note the procedure findDLSamples. You can use it to retrieve samples from a certain split. Additionally, this procedure can be helpful if you organized your dataset with custom keys, for example, the camera setup with which the sample was created. With object detection, you can optimize the inference results using parameters. Let's have a look at the DL result batch. You can see that every detected instance gets a confidence value between 0 and 1. With the min confidence parameter, you can apply a threshold to filter out results. Also, object instances may overlap. Max overlap determines the allowed overlap of the same class. In this example image, a low max overlap filtered out overlapping detections of the same class. In contrast, the parameter max overlap class agnostic sets the allowed overlap independently of the class. Note the result here when using a low max overlap class agnostic. Let's see some more inference results. Next, we use the standard procedure EvaluateDL model to evaluate the test split. Then, with DevDisplayDetectionDetailedEvaluation, we visualize the evaluation. At the top, we see some pie charts for the precision of all classes and the individual classes. As we can see, most instances that were found are correct. There are a few false positives. Some instances have a wrong class, and some bounding boxes seem to be badly located. For the evaluation, the intersection over union, or IOU, is used to determine whether a detected instance is correct or not. The IOU is calculated as the area of intersection divided by the area of union of the predicted and the ground truth bounding boxes. A common threshold is 0.7. If the IOU is equal or larger than 70%, the instance is considered correctly located. You can adapt the display IOU threshold to better fit your application's evaluation requirements. At the bottom, pie charts for the recall are displayed. The recall here shows that most instances that were labeled were also found correctly. False negatives refer to instances that were labeled but not found by the model's inference. Then a confusion matrix is displayed. With this matrix, you can compare the ground truth labels with the predicted classes. Ideally, you would have all instances on the green diagonal where the ground truth matches the inferred prediction. In this area, you would see any instances that are classified incorrectly. At the bottom, the false negatives are counted, instances that were labeled but not found. On the right, false positives are listed. Here, for example, some instances were located incorrectly. Lastly, I added some code to the example. First, we display samples that include both false positives and false negatives. Here is a good example for an interesting effect. This pill is labeled as a class 1, but classified as a 6. This counts as both a false negative, because the 1 has not been found, and as a false positive, because a non-existing 6 is detected. Next, we display some samples that contain only false negatives. As you may have noticed before, there are many false negatives, but only a few false positives. This often happens when a training did not run long enough. A simple fix may be to increase the number of training epochs. This concludes this video. Now, when the evaluation is satisfactory, we only have to deploy the inference, which we will learn about in the last tutorial of this series. Thank you for watching.